upcoming D&D campaign is rated TVMA LSVEP. It contains strong language, sexual situations, violence, extreme nerdiness, and proper naughty behavior. It is intended only for a mature audience. Viewer discretion is advised.
Happy Sunday, everyone. Welcome to another session of the Obsidian Scar. Let's just get right into it since we're running a little bit behind. Can I please get everybody's rolls?
16 for Ileana.
16.
15.
15.
Three.
11.
11.
20.
20. I rolled an 11. Steven, what are you doing?
Nice, Steven. Nice. Awesome.
We are in
this
sync.
Like 3 weeks in a row or something that you rolled like right on.
Nice.
Awesome.
Yeah. I've been doing pretty well.
Yeah, you have. Good job. Nice.
Only in this part.
GG. I think I said it a couple weeks ago too. You're the only one who uses it, so you might as well be the one that uses it.
Fair.
I need it so I can fail twice.
Mm-hmm. Yep, absolutely. We'll check on the roll and the TBMA. Steph, take it away with a recap.
Oh, well, let me just bring up my notes here from last week. From the re- mm-hmm. Yep. Okay. Last week, we were at our house in Jerasa. Sebastian and his mom left, so we went out shopping, went to a magic shop and got a bunch of, you know, stuff, and, then we went to a furniture shop and ordered some stuff as well, which, so now the house is furnished, at least we have beds, you know, but everything looks good, so that's a plus. Never really even partially owned a house before, so it's interesting. Bedroom to yourself. Mm-hmm. We went over to Florida's Baked Goods and talked a bit with Clara. Clara had her meet Fen, but also introduced Fen to bacon that she had never had before. So she seemed to like it. Thank goodness, because if she didn't, I believe Linnick would have had an aneurysm. Then while some of us went to the beach, Finn was kind enough to give me some swimming lessons. And I think I did pretty good. I think I was catching on. But while we were doing that, Jules stayed behind and got to know Clara a little bit better on the couch, I think, as the furniture people were bringing in the furniture. Not going to think about that too much. So then later we all got dressed up and went out. We talked with Clara. We came back to the house to get some drinks. And and went up for... Oh, we also played Truth or Dare. Yeah. Yeah, which was an interesting game. Better than Spin the Bottle, but that's just my opinion. And then the next morning we, getting up and our plans are to go and go to the assembly, Aelius Assembly Guild Hall. So to do a little bit of looking around, I guess. And that's it. Here we are.
All right. Well, next morning, Jules, you do find that Clara has left for the day. She has to open up the bakery. But the rest of you, what are you up to?
I mean, getting up?
Yeah. Stretching?
Yeah, probably hydrating. Doing some stretching, sure.
Yep. Yeah.
Doing some hydrating.
I'm doing yoga.
Oh, by yourself?
Sometimes you want to do it by yourself.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, sometimes.
Nice. Yeah.
I mean, Finn's doing actual yoga. Awesome. This is just getting
confusing.
Yeah.
Welcome.
We
need a yoga one and a yoga two. We need to decipher which one is
yoga
which one.
And hot yoga.
Yes,
nice.
Exactly.
Nice.
There you go. I'm doing
the
yoga.
Yeah. Yeah.
I thought that was a euphemism for the longest time.
Oh, hot yoga. It's no.
It's not.
Although it's really great. I love
it. Imagine so. Yeah. I mean, I would assume that probably Iliana would probably sleep in a bit, stay in bed for a bit with Linnick, and kind of slowly get up for some breakfast. And
yeah, I guess we're just waking up one at a time until we're all ready to go.
Have you seen my
plans? I don't have any plans this morning. Do you guys?
I think you took them off downstairs, Linnick. You took everything off downstairs, so it's probably all down there.
Oops.
Or in the street.
Do you need to borrow? You kind of took them off outside. Do you need to borrow anything? Do you?
Maybe a robe, if that's all right.
You're going to wear a robe today, downstairs?
Right, I'll just go get my clothes. And
okay.
Probably better.
Okay. You can wear a robe going outside if you want, or not.
I'll just borrow your robe. Right.
Okay, sure.
Thank you, and I'll put on a nice extra short robe. It's a comfy robe.
Yeah. Well, sure. It's very comfortable.
Well, this is lovely. And I'll go collect my clothes and then start making coffee and join everyone.
That's true. It's true. Ileana's like separating the underwear from last night and making sure that she washes it at some point today. That Jules wore during the truth or dare, just to make that clear for those watching.
Wow.
There's a reason.
Yeah.
I don't always talk about my characters cleaning their underwear, but that's why.
You offered them so hastily.
I did.
Well, nice. I mean, it was great.
It was so fast.
Jules was looking fine.
Yeah.
Right. So, big talk today then, right?
With Rory?
Do I have any questions?
It might be kind of awkward. Do we all want to go there, or do we just want to? I don't know this person.
We've all went before, right?
Not me.
I don't think.
I mean, there were three of us that went to see her. Because didn't we go to see her when we came in from when Jules and Derek was Exodus was there? But there were three of us, so I don't see how two more would throw them off and be like, "Oh no."
That's true.
Yeah, I think we're fine.
And this is the person who's actually a dragon, correct?
They took over the previous Rory when the previous Rory was killed by werewolves and took their form. And I can't remember what type of dragon she is, but I can think about it for a minute.
I don't remember it either. That's going to be some note looking. I've been sure where I'd have that written down at, so...
You're talking. I'm sorry. So
what is the question?
Not even going to.
That you're trying to remember.
Yeah, I don't think I wrote it down.
And also, Clara wanted to come. If I remember correctly.
Yeah. Right. She's gonna slip out of work when we get.
Oh, that's right. But she was wanting to kind of sneak it around, right? Like she wasn't wanting to. Right? Was she wanting to be seen? No, she wanted to come
because they wouldn't talk to her.
Okay.
That was the whole thing.
Yeah, we'll take him in. I mean, we'll take her in. Sure.
No.
Are there any questions that we have for Commander Rory? We don't have any updates, I think.
I mean, I guess like why people that are no longer mentally enslaved are wanted.
Sure.
It's a pretty big question.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's all I can think of, really. And then what was the task she gave us regarding the dragons? What was her whole thing? Does anybody?
I thought you would have wrote that down, Jules, since you're the one that's interested in dragons.
It's
Titan's heart.
Just really fast so that you guys remember. The three of you were there the last time to go get your bounties off of your head, but all five of you were there the time before to talk to her.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I'm still going to act like there were only three.
I just want to remember,
Well, there were two things I think that we were going to choose, but they need that Titan's heart, a sapphire dragon or something like that. So we could either retrieve that and help out with that, or I don't know, there was, they needed research to find out where that the Titan's weapon was.
Yeah, or, well, they're building it, right? It's like a fucking Megazord, right? It's a...
I think they're resurrecting a...
Oh, right.
No, but it's like a mountain or something, right?
It's like a body of land
that they're making come alive or something.
I think they're making a pizza into a werewolf.
They're putting eyeballs on a cheese pizza. And then...
Oh, no!
Axel's ears are burning! All I wrote down from Elzaris's notes were talk to Rory, the gold dragon, and Lady Amara, and something about Meridian's passage.
Right. I feel like there were two choices that, right?
Yeah.
Help just get that item, which seemed mighty dangerous, or do some sort of digging about for something, but I don't.
We are very professional adventurers.
Indeed. Well, perhaps we can just ask again. Happened.
It's been a weird couple of weeks.
We can ask her. I'm sure that she wouldn't mind refreshing us.
Before we deliver crepes to an Archfey in the Feywild.
Sure. Yeah.
She said so true.
Yeah. I could have sworn that someone we were like, whoa, what's a Titan? And they were like, oh, it's part of our Earth. It comes alive.
I didn't
there was something fucking weird. I swear.
Ileana didn't care, so I didn't write it down. So
it has no earthly idea what is happening. No, just
sworn, you have an like, oceanly idea?
It's alive, made out of a mountain.
Can we just go and ask?
Let's go find out. The worst case, she thinks a little less of us, but...
Yeah.
You know, I don't know how highly she thinks of us already, so...
Let's go. It's okay. It's all right.
Right. Jules, should we all stop by and get Clara together?
Yeah, let's go.
Right.
Pick her up.
Right, close, and I'll change. Yeah. Lead the way.
Good thing. And then, we'll go to the bakery.
All right, so you head out to the bakery. Clara had said she'd make you breakfast if you came by in the morning, so if you head over, she'll have it ready for you. And
good.
You see her busy. Obviously, it's her rush hour, but she takes a moment to greet all of you as you sit down. Of course, breakfast will be over in just a second. Do you have a time that we were going to meet?
Whenever works for you. I mean, our day is kind of
both. Whenever you are. Earliest of conveniences.
Yeah, we don't want to fuck up your rush hour.
No, I can leave my associates run the shop whenever your appointment was.
We didn't have a time like drop-in. We're just going to be a drop-in sort of thing.
Oh, okay. All right, so you want to do that now then?
We were going to go after breakfast, yeah. If you were okay with that.
Of course, yeah, of course.
Okay.
I'll see you outside the assembly hall when you're ready. Okay. You won't see me, but...
Okay.
All right.
Cool.
Sounds good.
Yay.
Meet you there.
Okay. All right. We'll see her get back to it because it is busy.
Oh, yeah. We'll just have breakfast and then walk over there and somehow be surprised that she got there before us.
Bacon!
Nice, yeah.
That's all Finn cares about now is bacon and Derek Parsons.
Ooh, nice. Second sandwich for the road.
Hey, she needs her strength, man. She's a beast.
Okay. All right. So you guys make it over to the assembly hall. And as much as you remember it being the main space that opens up to the three stories with the balconies on each level, the giant table that's in the center where they've started carving out the islands into a map, into a stone table. So you can see that there's been a lot of adventuring done since the last time you left. There's a huge bulletin board that has all of the different bounties on people's heads, different quests, things of that nature that the assembly has put out. And of course, you know the way to Commander Rory's office, which is sort of back and to the back. But you see that sort of like a bustling space of, you know, other adventurers, some that look as equipped as you, some that look a lot less equipped than you. And a handful of what look like the guards of the assembly that are kind of milling about.
Can I take a quick gander at that bounty board and see if there's anyone in our ship crew that's on there?
Sure. We make a quick perception check for me, please. Mm-hmm. Or investigation.
Thank you.
Would it be all right if I did the same, but just look for anyone I recognize?
I rolled a 15.
A 15? Okay. I'll wait until...
Which one did you want me to do? Investigation or... they're either. The same. Yeah. They're, sorry. Yeah. 19.
Okay. Okay. So you both are taking a look. Jules, you do see the bounty that has the list for the crew of the Maiden's Gem. And so some of your crewmates that you've hired are on that list. You know, you would have known or noticed that they didn't leave the ship when you guys docked in Jerasa. Those handful of people know they have a bounty out on them and stayed on the ship. But you do see that they are on that bounty.
But also, like, known mind-controlled people are also on that list?
Yeah, the whole crew, the entire crew is on the list,
But the list is much more than that, right? It just happens to include them.
Well, the bounty, there's like different bounties up for like mercenaries that have like gone rogue and stuff, but there's like one that's up for the crew of the the Maiden's Gem.
Does it say when it was posted?
You know that it was posted the last time that you came here, so it's been up for at least several weeks.
We can talk about breakfast for upwards of 2 hours.
Will you please talk about breakfast for just one moment while I grab my
name? I hope they don't find me.
This bacon's so good.
Right? It's crunchy and it looks like it's not, but when you bite in, it's just, it's got that perfect crunch.
So good.
Yeah, and Derek's just got like a whole loaf of bread that that he's eating and drinking at Derek Barton.
Nice.
So you created the drink.
I guess I did. I didn't expect it to catch on like that, but it is delicious.
It's so fucking good.
Oh, I'm glad you like it. I like it when people like things named after me.
Yes.
Well, I get that.
There's berries too.
There's berries
named after Derek. Barts and berries,
And berries.
Real juicy berries.
I never actually ate one.
They drip down.
You can't make
the real.
Make
real
mess, no matter what.
You gotta wipe your chin every time, okay?
Yeah.
I put my berries, I gave them to my horse, and he was into
All right. They're magnificent berries.
Some people are.
You gave your berries.
Speaking of which, where's my horse right now?
He's blushing.
Where's the only thing in this world I care about?
On the ship. I assumed you brought them with you.
Oh, that's great.
Oh, man. Okay. Can you make a quick history check for me, please? It's a pretty deep cut.
Okay. 19. I don't have a super good one for that. It's just
19. There are a couple. It's kind of hard. There's a lot of things that are like layered over things, you know. So you really start focusing on the list from the Maiden's Gem. Mm-hmm. But you do notice that there are some postings up there that are for people that say that they're specifically from Vedras, that there are people from Vedras, which is that first town that you visited when you first came here, that are wanted. But you're having trouble remembering if you met any of those people or if any of the names sound familiar. Yeah.
Thank you.
Oh, wait, what about the wonderful mother and father? Oh, wait, I don't know them. Never mind.
Yeah.
Never mind.
Yeah.
Jules doesn't know them.
Yeah.
Is this board assembly only, or is it also a community board?
They will allow you to take jobs if you're not a part of the assembly, but they won't pay you nearly as much if you're not a member.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll Should we
Except ask? For bounties. Bounties are just flat bounties. Oh. So.
Yeah. Okay. So I guess we'll just... is there like a front desk person there, or is it just kind
Secretary.
Of...
Secretary.
No, they still have not put in this elusive front desk that you guys keep asking about. I mean, there are the... You know, the offices, and you know where Commander Rory's office is, and you see some of the guard members that are around, but other than that,
I'll walk over. I think it's like a staircase in the back that leads up to her office or something, right? Does that sound right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'll just start heading over there and see if I can walk up.
Yeah.
All right, so you guys head out and over around to the direction of her office. Mm. No one seems to stop you, it's pretty busy today.
Okay.
But the door to our office is closed at the moment.
I'll knock.
Just a minute, please. And it'll be just a couple of minutes before she comes and kind of swings open the door hurriedly and says, you lot.
Hi.
Hi, how can I help?
Do you have just a few minutes? We had a question about submissions and such, but...
Truly, only a few minutes.
Yes, and then our friend Clara also has a question she'd like to ask.
Clara?
She's with us, right?
No.
Oh, she's not? Oh, never mind. Oh. Well.
Oh. I think she was going to sneak in and listen.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, she's going to be there, but not sneak in.
Mm-hmm. All right. Quickly, though. All right.
Certainly.
All right. And she'll kind of hurry you in and shut the door behind all of you and take a seat. How can I help?
I'll quickly mental message, I guess, Jules. Do we know what Clara's question was?
She never told me.
All right.
No, well, I'm asking. I was never told what Clara wanted.
She said that she needed time to look around while you guys were talking to her.
Okay.
Gotcha.
Mm-hmm. Right. So, Commander Rory, it's a pleasure to see you again, of course. We had a couple of questions. We've been going a little bit of everywhere. We have to head to the Feywild in a bit. But we were trying to sort our notes out about how we can... Nope, and we just couldn't recall exactly the ways in which we could help. I remember we could either acquire... Sorry, is it alright to speak freely here?
I hope that that's your friend that came in with you. And she kind of looks at the corner and where you guys don't see anything at all.
Yes. But yay, hi.
There's no reason to be invisible here. And she'll look at you, Jules. Maybe don't give away your friend if she's trying to sneak in.
It wasn't made very clear, to be fair.
Sometimes her notes get mixed up.
You could have just told me you were going to
get invisible. Well, it's been nice playing without everybody.
And you'll see Clara going invisible and kind of like shoot you a look, Jules. And say,
hey, I'm sorry. But it's like,
it's fine.
You know.
It's fine. Well, I'm here now, so. Right. So.
Sorry.
You're looking for decided you're in a position to help them.
We think so. We just couldn't remember what the second way was. That there was grabbing the Titan's heart or helping find that, and then there was a second thing, I think.
Right. Well, situation has changed a little bit since you were here.
All right.
So it depends on how it is you want to help. You can certainly still help look for the Titan's heart. It's going to be a bit of a quest. You'll be out for a long time. I thought when you last left, though, that you were looking to help with some of the negotiations.
Yes.
Of course, if you change your mind, I don't care.
Nope, we were looking to help with negotiations, yes.
I see. Well, honestly, right now, the two things that we really need are either some information on the Titan itself that they're trying to resurrect in the Margatis Trench. It would need to be a reconnaissance mission, but if you could find out exactly what's going on, how far along they are, we could use that information in the negotiations with the Giants.
All right.
Okay. There's a second thing?
of course you could be present for if you so wish. The second, and you'll see her sort of like nervously look around the room. Sorry, it's been a busy day. Well, we know when we find the Titan's heart, we're going to need some magic to contain it. And the best way we know how is that of a blood of a serpent that's out in the Barra Waste. So we need someone to go out there and collect it. And unfortunately, I don't have any mercenaries here that I could trust or are talented enough to go and acquire it.
Guessing this is a large serpent, not just a...
They're quite large serpents, yes. And they often travel in packs, but if you injure one gravely enough, the rest will flee, leaving that one.
Sort of kind of serpent.
Something special to these isles. I have never seen them before coming here. They I've gone out only once. But
are they poisonous?
They're poisonous, and each seem to have their own sort of abilities, almost like dragons, but not.
Interesting.
Ooh. Now, as far as information on that, the Titan are trying to who is it? Which group is trying to resurrect that?
The giants.
Yes, right. Yes. The Titans were part of their ordning before they were slain.
And what's the name of that trench again?
Margatus.
Margatus. Thank you very much. Right. Well, I guess. Is everything all right here? Is there anything we can help out with while we're here?
Oh, I think I mentioned last time that the whole reason I'm here, I'm trying to help lead the dragons, but I'm not really here for them. I'm here to try and take down the assembly as best I can. And they seem to be moving quickly, not caring about either the immigrants that have come here for them or the natives that live here. And I have to do my best to appear as though I am Commander Rori. God rest her soul. And I can't ask as many questions, but I know that they're trying to move on some dangerous items that were left behind the last time the assembly were here.
Oh, right.
So we're just in the midst of trying to figure out exactly how it is we're going to stop them.
Well, if we end up coming through and there's something we can do to help with that, I don't want to speak for everyone, but I imagine we'll be, you know, it's within our capabilities. We'd probably be up for helping with that, taking out the assembly or helping cut them back.
It's honestly up to you. If you want to focus on helping with the giants and the dragons, and then that should be your focus. If you want to help us here with the assembly, of course, we'll take the help.
All right.
I don't want to pull you in too many directions.
Of course. I guess, does anyone else have a question or Clara or anyone?
Regarding the wanted board, we noticed that the ships that my friends came in on, the entire crew is wanted. Do you have any notes on that?
Oh, Jules, that's kind of a strange situation. The main gem crew worked for the assembly, as you know. Yeah. And the heads came down and said they betrayed us and they're wanted, so we put up the bounty. But I've heard some strange reports of them being sighted, and I don't know, they're not acting in ways of those who are on the run. They keep stopping in ports that are run by the assembly. You would think that someone who's on the run wouldn't do that. But I don't have much information.
Well, I know that they're all being mind controlled.
Mind controlled.
I know that sounds ridiculous, but...
Not to me, no. I've heard of such magic.
So yeah, and then also if we could get a couple names crossed off that list for now, as they are now in our employ.
Oh, I see. Right.
The ones we've rescued so far.
Of course. Just give me the names and I'll make sure that they're removed from the bounty.
Sure. And then I'll just, like, I'll write down all the names.
Do you think the entire crew is mind-controlled and therefore the bounty should be taken down?
So...
We can't really account for the captain or Jefferson.
And we also can't account for their actions as they are currently.
I see.
So they were known to be at Red Bones Bay, delivering slaves that were also under a similar type of control. So whatever's going on might be tied in with that.
Slaves.
Aye, yeah. There was some what was his name there that Elzaris's father. Sea wolf was there.
The sea, yeah.
It was now on the run.
Aye, with Elzaris, who used to travel with us, has left us to go with him.
Be a pirate.
So be careful if she returns. Just apparently want to give it a heads
they
up.
Were apparently they were here, because remember Claire said that she saw them or saw Exardus at least.
I did. Yeah, they were in town. All right.
But yeah, they're together. So I don't know if we need to put up a wanted sign for that or something. I don't know. Just.
I see. Right. I can if it's not a bounty that we would necessarily be paying, but if it's a bounty you want paid, of course we can put it up.
Yeah, I'll put 2 gold. I'll put a 2 gold mounting on it.
All right.
I think that's about what it's worth.
Right. All right. I'll put you in touch with our records keeper, and they can put a bounty for you.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Now, did you?
Asha will remember this.
Did they speak with you?
No, I wasn't aware they were in town.
Oh.
Right, I've never met the sea wolf in my life, and I hadn't seen Elzaris come through. But this is quite concerning. So I suppose you have a third option. If you want to find out exactly what's going on with the rest of the crew.
I would, if possible, when you update the bounty list, just note that as far as we know, if you remove the curse, they're cursed, so you can take them alive. You don't have to kill the crew.
Right. I'm concerned, though, that if the
assembly,
memories are modified by the assembly themselves, I couldn't put that on bounty.
Right.
They're going to see it.
Hey.
If you were the ones to find them, then you would know, but I can't.
Understood. Mm-hmm. Understood. You know, I wonder if it would be, I don't know if it's possible or if it matters anywhere, but it might be good to just say that the ones that we've are fine now are dead and the ship was lost so that people aren't looking for that ship as it's now out with some friends of ours that are taking good care of it. Well, is that manageable? It's under a different name.
That might be manageable, yes. Let me think on it first.
Of course.
Only because I don't want to raise suspicions.
That's right. I wouldn't want to risk that.
Right. But I'll do my best, and I will try and protect him as much as I can. But
yeah, I mean,
when the bounty is public, it's public.
Your work here, of course, is paramount. So please don't weigh that any less just for us.
Right. And then I guess Clara, if you have any questions.
I guess my major question is just to make your acquaintance. I feel like perhaps we could be allies, and maybe we can talk more when you aren't as rushed or busy. I've been trying to do my own work, trying to find out a little bit more about this simply.
I mean, it seems like you both fucking hate the assembly, so I think that's something to have drinks over.
Mm. Oh,
right. Perhaps.
And Commander, I was just wondering if I've heard word through our travels that the assembly, or at least someone in the assembly, might be after me, or you know, have their sights set on me. I just thought I'd ask and see if you were aware of anything that might. Have any insight into that?
I hadn't looked into it, but if you're concerned about it, then I can keep my ear to the ground and let you know.
I appreciate it.
Of course.
Thank you, Commander.
Of course. Well, what are you thinking of doing?
Well, okay, this is going to sound weird, but we need to go buy some crepes really quick before we do anything.
Yeah.
All right.
It's a long story.
There's an archfey and there's...
No, it's a whole thing. It's a
impulse.
Thing. All you had to say was archfey. I get it. Yeah. All right. Well, do you want the information now on what you're going to do, or would you like to just come back and
I guess, I don't know. What do you guys think? I would probably vote for the giant, personally. My ranking would be giant's crew. Sorry, go ahead.
I was going to say, you want to take the hardest thing first.
Yeah, just bang it out. Just get out of the way.
That's what you said last night.
Were you there last night? I can't remember. No, I'm being honest. This is Emilio's asking. Did you join us? I couldn't remember.
No, she didn't.
I thought she did. Didn't she?
I did, but I didn't know if that's if, what.
Nice. Oh, what? That's not an answer.
No, I was there, but I didn't know that.
I don't want to take up much more of your time. I know you're busy. We can talk about it while we're delivering crepes and figure out.
All right.
Well, I mean, but the thing is, she has information for us regardless, regarding which we choose. So we might want to.
Serpents. If you can make your way back to Helena or somewhere in Vog Maldir or one of our other locations, I can have the information sent to you there if you're not ready to make a decision.
So, Jules, when you say giant, you're talking about the info in the Titan, correct?
Because we were going to
help with negotiations.
I think either negotiations or the serpent blood.
I'd vote for negotiations still. We have, well, Pepino's not here, but I think that we're well suited for that, or better suited for that. And then if that falls through, perhaps we can fall back on one of the others, but...
Just to be clear, the negotiations wouldn't happen until you went on the recon mission to look at the Magartis Trench and see where they are.
Oh, all right.
We can't have those negotiations. We're in a bit of a stalemate right now.
Understood.
So the info on the Titan is what we're
looking
at.
Right, the info on the Titan. But then you could help us with the negotiations, of course.
Yeah. No, I think the info on the Titan, sure. That's, Jules, that's what you're talking about, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, no offense to the thing, things going on in the assembly.
Right.
We can save whoever we find from the Maiden's Gem as we see them. But again, this feels like some end of the world shit.
Right.
I mean, sure.
Right, I suppose the reconnaissance then, if that's our gateway to negotiate, being in the middle of negotiations, I suppose that's what we'll have to set our sights on.
Yeah, yeah.
Info on the Titan.
Right. Let me get you some information. You can look it over. Reach out to me if you have any questions. Other than that, I guess just be in touch with what you know.
Okay.
Right.
And she'll reach into her desk drawer and pull out this envelope. That's kind of like thick. You can tell there's paper and other things that are in this envelope, and she'll just hand it over to one of you. I don't know who's gonna take it, but
Ileana will take it, sure.
Okay. All right. Well, if there's nothing else, Clara, it's good to make your acquaintance. Young woman. You didn't introduce yourself.
Well, I'm Finfrin, or you could just call me Finn for short. It's just what everyone does because it's easier. Yeah.
All right. Finn, it's good to meet you.
You too. She'll just hold out a hand.
She'll reach out and shake it. Her like large half-orc hand will envelop yours. All right. Okay. Well, if there's nothing else, And she'll kind of look at Clara. Five entered. And Clara, like, yes, of course. And she'll go invisible. All right. What are you guys up to?
I'm going to go set up that bounty.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So you take the piece of paper she gave you and you find one of the guards. They point you to the gentleman that does all of the record keeping, and it's like, great. Thank you. I will be in touch as soon as the bounty is picked up on.
Make sure you put that she's, like, you know, not dangerous and just kind of just awkward on there.
Okay. And yeah. The other?
The other?
The other that she travels with?
Possibly dangerous.
Oh, very, yeah, much more dangerous.
I see. All right.
Likes ropes. I don't know. How would you guys describe him?
No, that's pretty accurate.
Very, very conniving. So be extra careful with him.
Yeah.
I see. And 2 gold is the bounty for both of them.
Oh my god.
Derek steps up and he hands I'm sorry. I was going to role play and then I was just going to talk. Do we give him the gold? My question first, do we turn in the gold prior to the bounty being turned in and then they give the gold over?
Yeah, they'll do it because they'll want it as soon as...
Okay. Yeah. Derek steps up with... 2 more gold.
So it's gonna be 3.5 gold for the man, and then 5 silver for the woman.
I see. Understood.
Yeah. Alive.
Worth more than that.
Yeah, but alive.
Oh god.
I hate you so much.
and we don't.
Derek
have to
thinks
play
he
as
was
part
actually
of
being real solid.
Can you can you give me a Jules description so that I can have it on their own?
Jules will give a very vivid description of Elzaris.
Mm. Right. To go cup. Don't forget, she'll be carrying a to go cup.
Yeah, I'll draw like a little doodle of her. Like,
you would know, Jules.
Perfect. I'll take your doodle.
It's going to be a little comic of her like complaining about food.
Oh, or okay. Something like that.
Nice. Poor character.
Okay. All right. Well, I'll get this taken care of right away.
Thank you. Thank you for your service.
I'm just so like. Oh my god.
That's what happens. That's what happens. That's what you get.
We're gonna teach you a lesson.
That's what you get.
Oh, we're so gonna silly. Put a bounty on your head, and you're gonna be worth shit.
Yep. Then you won't be bothered by people or an endless stream of noobs that are like 2 gold, sweet, like 3.
Yeah,
and it's you're like just gonna murder them all.
A bunch of level one
tipping a waiter 50 cents on a credit card.
As of right now, at the beginning of every session, we'll have to have Tasha roll to see if these noobs take her down or not. She's gonna have a new set of mercenaries every week.
Oh, I hate all of y'all.
All right. It's what you get.
Yeah. So it wasn't me. It was not me.
Sure. Nice.
Mm-hmm. All right. What do you guys
do? I'll just... ask everyone if they mind. You can all go ahead if you wish or stay. I'm going to take a quick peek and see. No, I already looked at the bounties. I'm just going to take a minute and sketch some more of this map into my notes. If there's anything new, I just want to take a minute and take a look.
Stay here with you.
We should start planning on how we're going to get to.
All right. Yeah.
Because unfortunately, we're on a time limit for that.
So. Well, I'll have
the
twig
grapes.
For Javier, and then we can get to Vog
Maldir.
Well,
we're on a time limit once we get, once we get them.
Oh, no, I thought we had, like, 2 weeks from
there.
We
do, yeah. We have time, yeah, I mean, so, right. But we'll get to time.
I think it's 3. I think we have time, right, if we use the twig, and then right over, right, because that's before the pass.
We get the things,
Or in the pass, or at the... beginning of the past there, right?
Yeah.
Hey, and then I think you said you had someone there in the college. Wait, that was
gave me a name that of someone I can talk to that could possibly help us.
Oh, right. Oh, go Maeve. Excellent. I'll just check and see if the map has anything updated that I don't have in my notes.
So you take a look. There's a little bit of extra detail within the main aisle and a couple of the small aisles that are sort of right next to the main aisle, but nothing. Now that you've gotten the pirates map, that sort of give you the outline of the aisles, there's nothing like much further out. But you are able to like fill in that little bit that, to like make your map a little bit more accurate.
Gotcha. Okay. All right. So, you know, just I'll do that and then I'll catch up maybe over at Clara's, wherever everyone says they're going.
Oh, yeah. I would have stayed there. Hung out. Went to the bounty
board. I'm going to go back and get as much reading done as I can in that book that I bought.
Okay. How many hours do you want? Because this probably would have just been a couple hours this morning, so.
Yeah. I'll read until the group's ready to leave.
Okay.
Pretty much.
I would say Ileana's kind of standing there waiting for Linnick. She kind of go up to the table. So are you really worried about your people coming after you, the assembly?
So, I mean, part of me falls out of my head and I don't think about it, but then I worry that I should probably be worrying a bit more. Clara told me just before we left her also the first time, or the second time, maybe the first time, that... Thanks.
Yeah.
That some people might be looking for me.
Yeah, you told us about it, I think.
Right. I can't remember how much I told you. I think I covered most of it with my family and such from the first time the assembly was here.
I think so. Yeah.
All right.
That's your ancestor. Kind of maybe, and she kind of looks around and steps closer. Founded the Isles, or
was going to be one of the founding members while joining, you know, the assembly. But they were killed, and believe it was from some of the others
from the assembly.
Right, perhaps the a particular family that I think is still the Flynns, and I believe it's the twins that are here. That are the two of the leaders of the assembly. In fact, maybe still the same, as I think they're elves. It was something passed down to my family, and my mother was almost a zealot for it. Just it was her life's mission to pass that on, and even from a young age. It ate away at her. And of course she was a fairly terrible person already, but there was a lot of hate bound up in that. Anyway.
She was upset that she didn't get, that she wasn't recognized, her family?
It was something that was almost passed on, this anger at it all. And every single misfortune that, and there were many, was just attributed to that. No personal responsibility.
Sure. Yeah.
It never made sense to me, but after my mom passed and I heard of the calling of the assembly heading to these aisles, I just a big part of me wanted to come here for a new start. But there's a part of me, I'm almost angry that it's there. It felt you on behalf of my mother and family.
You want to find out.
But apparently they know my lineage, and so I don't know what they might be wanting. Maybe just to eliminate me, so there's, you know, I don't know how it works, whether someone can make any sort of claim or anything, but I don't think that they like that, having that black spot on their record or whatever it is. So.
Sure. Well, we'll keep an eye out.
I appreciate that. Sorry for all the trouble that follows me.
My empire is trying to kill me. So I think, yeah. You don't need to be sorry. Okay. Well, if you see anything or anything looks suspicious to you, just let the group know, okay?
Right. I will. If I see something, I'll say something.
Sure. Okay. If I see anyone giving you the eye that's not me, I'll cut him down.
Yeah. I'm glad you're on my side.
Just get around looking.
Okay, what are you guys doing?
Meeting up?
Nella.
Yeah.
Eliana's gonna cut a bitch.
Nice.
Yes.
It's not the way I meant it as a player, but I realized how it sounded after it came out. So.
Giving you the eye.
Yeah, I love it. I will
cut them down.
Yeah.
I will cut
a bitch. Yeah, just meet up and make sure, you know. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna make a side trip, and I'll message you in whatever this is, Zoom, super quick. But then I'll meet up with everyone. So.
All right. What is everyone else doing then?
Still just reading until ready to leave.
Okay.
Derek wants to try and procure a, for lack of a better word. Whoa.
Yes, Derek, I'm with you. That is not that. For once, that reaction isn't for you. Go ahead, keep going.
Oh, it's not. Okay.
I'd like to procure a tabaxi-sized cat bed for the living room.
Okay. Yeah, you can absolutely do that.
Okay.
It'll be a gold. They'll make it for you and have it delivered.
Sick. I will gladly subtract that gold. That's worth twice as much as Elzaris.
Yes. Yes. Oh, and since you weren't here last week, if you want to decorate your room,
just
pull up the IKEA catalog, convert all of the dollars to copper pieces, and then just tell me how much you're spending.
I can tell you this. You do it all at once because you get one thing.
Mm-hmm.
I've been trying to get another bookcase like that for like three fucking months now.
Yeah.
And I don't have it. And I'm like, I don't want different colored bookcases.
Yeah, I know. It's tough.
I feel that.
I would purchase everything at once if I were you. Yeah.
Yes, it is known.
Delivery is included. Yeah.
Oh, yes. Ooh. Okay, thank you.
I got a seashell bed.
Oh, I saw that. That was lovely. Nice. Perfect character.
Not the swan bed? Was
it not the swan bed?
The swan bed.
No.
Okay.
Seashell.
Yeah. Is it like a big one that opens up, like Venus?
It's already there. It's already opened.
Nice.
It doesn't close. She don't have time for that. She was cool. She doesn't have time to open that shit up. She was like dive on in and sleep.
Mm-hmm.
Needs to be readily available.
I hear that.
Yep.
After either way, once I get back to the group, I guess I'll just ask are we planning to leave tonight, or should we get a good rest and then head out? Oh, right, because I can use the stick, right, to twit Javier's hefty branch here, and that'll get us closer.
Yeah.
And then it depends on where. Actually, I'm going to consult my book and see if I at all spot if any of that magic has worked to see Javier moving around. I don't know if that ever worked or not.
So you put it in, but I don't think you put Javier as your original spot. I think you were putting, I think you were focusing on Jerasa.
Right.
So you know that you have to put the magic in for each thing. So you can certainly work on that when you're with Javier. So
We can use that. And I mean, last we spoke, I think Javier said, you know, sort of travels about looking for his kin.
Yeah.
but it has to be closer than Jerasa, so.
Sure. Yeah, I mean.
And that's what looking at.
What time of the day is it again, Victoria? If you've already said, I'm sorry.
It's okay. It's probably about lunchtime by this point.
So I guess we could either get a good rest tonight here and not have to pay anything, or possibly take the Javier branch and get as close as we can to, I guess, the pass, or get to the pass.
Yeah, well, he might be closer to Vog. I mean, we have no idea where he's going to be, right? So he might be closer to Vog Maldir.
Well, see, the thing is, though, if we get to Bogler, we get there, I mean, we'd have to find our own. I mean, because once we get the crates, we have 24 hours. I mean, we wouldn't be able to get to the pass in 24 hours. So the contact that Maeve gave us for the teleport to get us straight to the Fae would be out.
No, but we, correct me if I'm wrong, but we could teleport just using some of the dwarven, like, kingdom stuff, right?
If we could find someone to do it for us. I mean, not everyone is hurdy-gurdy going to take us to the, I mean, we could ask.
I'm friends with that. Oh, God.
I'm on it.
Sure. Okay. So we can see where.
Friends with the.
We.
Thank you. Graham Frieda.
We can see where we come out at with the tree. And then right. If we're closer to there, then we can ask before we get the crepes. And then if we're closer to the pass, we'll stop at the pass, get the contact, and then head to the Dwarven City. I have such a hard time.
No crepes. And I'll just kind of look over Derek. We're not buying any at all. Because this magic, this whole deal is very specific. So if we get them, just for ourselves even, we run the risk of the second they're purchased having our clock start. So we want to get our ducks in a row first.
Wait, what?
Also, I can't have any crepes?
Don't buy any crepes here, because he said that from the moment you buy them, it didn't say for whom. So is how Faye can operate, so you have to be very careful.
Yeah.
There's a lot of...
We have to buy those crepes.
Right. I'm just mentioning to Derek. Just to be safe,
shouldn't...
They're really good, though.
I agree.
They wouldn't know.
They would know. It's their fancy magic.
They are particular.
Yes.
I agree.
Okay, but the whole deal is we have to go there, buy a specific crepe.
Right, we just have to get...
From a certain shop.
Let's just buy a few, just so we have some extras.
I promised extras. I was gonna do one of everything.
Oh, nice. That's a good idea. But right, we just want to make sure we line up all of our travel plans to Banff over there and everything else before anyone buys them, even for themselves. Like, I'm hungry. Yep. Let's get some breakfast. No,
in the Dwarven City. Yeah.
Right.
Okay. But once we're there, I think Graham Frieda could probably teleport us to.
Nice.
And the person that knows how to get to the Feywild is in the Casadothian Pass, correct?
Yes, correct.
Just to clarify. So we're going to teleport twice. Got it.
Right.
Maybe Javier knows how to get to the Feywild. It's worth asking him. Absolutely. While we see him.
Maybe he has a different part of him we can travel through.
Ileana will chuckle.
We're positive. This is the right city, right? We're It's Vog Maldir, right?
Yes, it's the crepe stand I took you guys to, from what I heard, from what I understand.
Yep. Okay, so do we want to do that? Do we want to start out today, or do we want to start out tomorrow morning?
I'm fine.
Well, if we start tomorrow morning, we have 4 days. Mm. So,
Yep.
We're on the 3 ninth
weeks.
Day.
I
thought we had 2 weeks.
Yeah.
It's 3 weeks, and you're 9 days in.
Oh, I thought we had 2 weeks.
Yeah, 3 weeks.
Oh, yeah, let's go tomorrow. Yeah,
on
a rush.
Right.
So take it easy today.
Derek, I know you didn't have a lot of time to relax with us yesterday evening, and I thought you've been working hard between whatever you're writing and adventuring and keeping us alive and such. And I thought, Derek, there's a man that needs some well-earned rest. So I hope you don't mind. I popped into your room and just left you a bit of a gift that I thought you might enjoy.
Oh. Oh.
It's hanging from your ceiling.
There's a gift from my ceiling?
Right.
Oh.
It's a surprise.
Okay, I'll be sure to go check it out. Thank you.
I'm excited.
Wow. Nice. Okay.
Nice. All right.
Are we going back home right now? Are we there?
I think we're home.
Okay, yeah, Derek goes to his room and looks.
Oh, okay. He's too excited. Hanging from a chain in your room, off the ceiling, is a bit of a sensor, like a incense bowl, and mm-hmm. it's stuffed with your catnip incense.
I knew it.
Oh yeah. Oh. Derek has a flint and tinder. Do I need to give it a little?
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah. Oh, Derek. Wait, was I? Was it gonna take time for my magic cat? Not magic, but for my cat bed to be made. I don't have it yet, do I? That's unreasonable.
It'll be there by the end of the. It'll be there by the end of the day. It's okay.
They're pretty quick workers, so yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. We ordered furniture in the morning, and everything was there by that evening. So.
Oh man, I love that.
But I mean, if you still want to use the couch, I get it.
It took Sebastian forever. No, Derek just wants to lay down and get high. That's
nice.
With catnip.
Uh-huh. He's been waiting for this.
I'll peek my head around.
Yeah, no, and he's too excited to even come out and tell you how thankful he is. He's
no worries. Like, oh. I put one in your room on the ship too.
Oh my god. I think this is the most thoughtful thing anyone's ever done for me, Steven.
So happy.
Nice. You take care, friend, then I'll give him a wink and and head back downstairs.
So happy.
My god.
Does Derek level up?
Yeah.
Spiritually, probably.
Amazing.
Do we have like stuff in the house to cook dinner?
Yes. You guys spent some party funds to stock the kitchen and everything, so you're good.
What should we make?
Artemis still here?
Mm. Oh, he's cruising about town. There's a different part of town he's in. We're gonna collect him before we head out. I'm gonna send him a message in a wee bit. Okay. But did you want him to
sort of food he eats?
Oh, I think he was eating some raw. He likes to hunt for his own food usually when it can.
It seemed like I was worried that Sebastian didn't have enough for him, and I thought it'd be nice if we could do something special for him.
A wonderful idea.
Okay, I'm gonna go get high.
Awesome. Is there any like seafood?
Do you have any fish?
I'm sure there's plenty.
Fish, snails. Oysters, snails? Mussels.
I've never had snails before, but
you like them or you don't.
I've cooked up fish starfish? Before.
Starfish?
I've never cooked up starfish before. No.
What? No, I'm not eating starfish.
It seems.
The fuck?
What is that? I mean, is it chewy? Is it a tough meat?
It's like jerky.
Like jerky.
Like textured jerky.
Okay.
I'm out.
No, yeah. I think that they're we passed.
Like dry them out, season them up, and so bad.
Might as well, I'll have to remember that.
Uh-huh.
I saw some lobster though. There's lobster and some fish and such we can in the market there.
Okay, yeah.
Yes.
I think.
Yeah, we can go and get some lobster. I mean, it's a poor town. Yeah.
Right.
Octopus.
Right. Ah, right. Mm-hmm. Let's see. I guess, right, seafood dinner it is.
Yeah,
it's been so long since I've had seafood for dinner.
Well, I mean, we've lived on a ship, so I feel like that we've had seafood for dinner a bit.
Yeah,
but okay, fish
yeah.
just
you
not.
Want, if everyone you want can to have it again.
Everyone can have fish. Like, that's what you have on a boat is fish.
What do you want him to have, then? I don't understand.
Mussels, oysters, clams, snails, okay, starfish,
I can't cook squid. Any of that. I can't. I'm out.
I've got you.
What if we got, like, a very big bird, right? And some veggies and some other stuff and just had, like, a big stuffed bird with
that sounds good,
some
honestly.
Cranberries and some of them, you know, or mash up some taters and such.
Yeah.
Crab?
I like
I heard
it.
Crab. Are we having crab?
Or we can have some shrimp with it. Sometimes I think there they have shrimp with stuff like that.
And nobody said crab. Nobody.
I heard crab.
We didn't
crab
say
sounds
crab.
Amazing.
Well, if you want to buy Lots some crab tail. And make it, sure.
Yeah, you can have
Snails.
Your own dinner.
Okay, right. We can get a bird. Caviar. Let's go. Let's all go and get some.
Pull
get
my
some
eye out.
Caviar, you know, like.
Yeah, you're supposed to have caviar sparingly, right? You're not supposed to just have like a fucking mountain of caviar.
It's a share.
It could be. Look, she's
but
from
I mean,
the sea.
Like...
Yeah. I'm a sea creature. Mm. I can eat that in a sitting.
It's okay. We're not accusing
saying,
you.
It's like,
we're
just
like talking.
Yeah, for like humans, it's like sparingly. For fish people, we have those for snacks.
Okay.
Nom, nom,
no
yum.
You know what
you
I like to have for snacks? Oh, Finn, have you ever had chocolate? Have you had chocolate? Have you?
Rarely. Oh, only when we went to Ikram were we. Oh.
Well, we can get some chocolate. I enjoy some chocolate.
Just kidding. Okay. I cannot have chocolate.
Oh.
I just no. I'm just trolling you, Tasha.
Oh, can you or you can't? Should we not? Can I eat chocolate around you? Would you be offended? Because.
Right.
I do.
What if I'm eating chocolate and I sneeze and it gets on you?
You know what? No,
what if
I
eat chocolate and I get sick and I throw up? Are you going to die?
Oh, no.
No. Why would
you?
Anyways.
You know, you get sick.
That's so specific.
I don't know.
I know.
It's tough to stop eating chocolate.
Why
and
die? Like, why jump straight to her dying?
She's
alive.
I think Jared has his goals and upstairs.
If she's allergic to chocolate, if it makes her sick, then if I get sick and she gets sick.
Oh, so your sickness makes the chocolate extra deadly.
Apparently.
That's how it works.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. Uh-huh. Is that not how
I can
have
it
works?
I just don't have
good.
It all the time.
All right. Well, we'll pick some up with a bird and such.
Seafood?
Okay.
It's just been so long since I've had really good seafood.
Well, no, you can pick up some seafood. We're going to pick up
just
a bird.
Like,
and
swim? Like, just grab a fish?
Well, I thought I would cook it for y'all, too.
Yeah,
we would welcome the company in the kitchen, sure.
Yeah.
That's lovely.
Okay. Well, y'all all eat seafood, or is it just like...
Yeah,
I feel like I've had a lot of seafood. I don't really want the seafood you're talking about. Not a ton of it. I'll try it, but I don't want it to be my main
meal. Just get the smaller portion.
Starfish.
Oh, no. They probably don't have starfish here. I doubt it.
Already.
I don't think any of us.
Doubt it. Okay, let's go. We're shopping. We're shopping for food.
Okay,
let's
we're going shopping.
Good.
We're shopping.
All right.
A half hour later.
Jeez. All right. So... You go out shopping. You go grocery shopping.
Yes. Market shopping. We're going to go to the market. Oh my God, I can't wait for the market.
You acquire the
stuffed
ingredients that you need. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Vegetables, potatoes, chocolate.
Mm-hmm.
Crab or shrimp or lobster. Whatever.
Shrimp.
Shrimp is fine.
Cranberries. Anything else, Linnick? Am I missing anything?
Well, that sounds good. We've got a little
alcohol.
I mean, plenty of chocolate, and we can make a little bit of a dessert there with it.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe some raisins. So if we make some dough, we've got stuff at home for dough and the cinnamon and sugar and such. Put some raisins in there. You roll it up like a little roly-poly. You bake it a bit, cut it. Oh.
Roly-roly?
Sounds
little
delicious.
Little roly-poly. Oh, it's fantastic.
Oh, roly-poly.
All right. Yeah. So you acquire everything that you're looking for to make dinner.
Okay.
Make your way back to your home. You find Derek. In his cat bed, enjoying his incense. Jules is reading, and that's where we'll go ahead and take our bio break. So if you're new around here, we take a quick 10-minute break so we can fill up our drinks, stretch, and we will be right back. So we'll see you soon. Yep. Mm-hmm. All right.
Yay.
Bye.
Mm-hmm. Bye. Mm-hmm.
All right, we're back. So you have all acquired what you wanted for your meals. Jules is making headway in his book.
Sorry.
Fen has a dog, and Derek is working on his catnap. What are you guys up to?
It's catnip catnap.
Ileana's probably trying to cook in the kitchen.
Yeah. I'm helping.
Get some of that sexy cooking action going.
It's hot. Mm-hmm. So I think Lena would be wearing like boxer briefs and an apron.
Of course you would. Yep. Yeah. Yep. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. Gonna help out, reach around as much as you can.
Ileana will give you a little bump with her hips.
Ooh, nice. Everybody's cooking food, checking in with Jules and Fen, and you know, asking if there's anything in particular they'd like. And
I was thinking, Lennox, maybe one of these nights we just have a little boys' night and just stay up late reading and making hot chocolates and
yes, please. Yeah. That sounds incredible.
Yeah.
I love it.
Right. Yeah. Just, you know, no rush. Just wanted to, you know, run it by you.
Oh, thank you.
Let Ileana know, you know, one of these days that, you know, it's my turn.
I'll catch up on my sleep.
Nice.
And then, yeah, just look at the tone, basically.
Okay. Cool. Yeah. Cool. Okay. Yeah, other than that, I don't think I have anything except for that.
Just cooking. Ileana would have bought some chocolate that she'll kind of like lay out put on the table for before dinner.
Yeah.
I'll light up whatever oven thing we have and keep an eye on the bird. Rotate the spin the rotisserie or whatever. I don't know what the setup is, but
you know,
he's cooking the seafood.
Cook birds. Yeah.
Nice. I've never seen that much hair go into a bun, Ben. That is incredible. Assuming you're keeping the
Did
hair
you put
out of
your hair
food.
Up?
I was like, my hair is being cooked in food?
No, putting your hair up in that top knot there. Yes.
I did.
It looks good. It looks good. Thank it's you. A lot of hair.
I know.
Yeah.
But it's nice. I like it.
Hey.
I hear some ladies are jealous. So.
Oh, who?
I see.
Those with like a lot of like this is just what I hear. Like a lot of ladies just like are jealous of the curliness and the volume and my luscious locks, man.
I can see that.
Sure. Mm-hmm. Sure. If that's what you want, then yeah.
Yeah. You just gotta lean into it.
If your hair curls like that, I guess you could have it straight, whatever type of hair you have, you could still be long.
Yeah. There's always magic, so you can do whatever you want.
Magic to make it on your hair?
To make it straight? Who would want that?
What would you even use? What kind of magic?
Straight hair? I don't know.
Or maybe their hair's very frizzy, and they just want it straight and neat.
My mind gets that way when it gets really hot in the summer.
Yeah.
Oh, right. See, I like Jules. I think Jules has the very best bun that I've seen date.
It's just a nice bun.
It's right. It's beautifully marked up.
You flatter me.
It looks very relaxed and lazy, but there's some engineering to it. I know it.
Mm-hmm. There's some structure there.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. I feel so seen. I feel so.
Well.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I don't know how Derek gets his fur like that every day. If I had that much hair.
I know.
I don't know how he keeps it so clean. So sometimes.
Matted. I would just have matted fur.
Yeah.
Oh. That's an extraordinary thing that he has going there.
Okay, I think dinner's done. Let's serve the food.
And then I'll sleep.
Yeah.
All right.
All right. So anything else you guys want to accomplish this evening before you head out?
I'm going to keep reading whenever I can. Okay. I know I'm under a time limit, so.
Yeah.
No.
Okay. All right. So you have a lovely night's sleep. Actually, most of you have a lovely night's sleep. Eliana, you actually find yourself with some dark, kind of restless dreams this evening. You're having a dream of a familiar battle. It's one of those battles that you're in that you tend to dream of over and over again. But this time, you see off in the horizon as you are battling this army of tieflings, just past them, this dark wall of cloud, and it almost seems sickly and oily and all-consuming, and it seems to be coming all the way across the horizon and coming straight towards everyone. And as everyone on the battlefield realizes that whatever this is heading straight for you, it seems like tiefling and human alike all start running in the opposite direction. Everyone that's on the battlefield is running. And your wings, although you did not have them at the time, come out and you take flight, and you just see these thousands of people that are running away from that cloud before it seems to almost consume all, if not most, if not all of them, before your dream goes black and you hear the voice of your Deva say to you, "They've run. They're coming. You'll see them soon." And it's just pitch black nothingness.
Eliana will probably kind of wake with a start from that.
Okay.
I'm assuming, unless they were doing their book thing tonight, which doesn't sound like it, that Eliana was probably in bed with Linnick.
He's probably snugged around holding a boob or something.
Yeah, so she would sit up, kind of jerk up. It's fine. It's right. Fine. Just a bad dream.
You sure? What happened? Sometimes it makes people feel better to talk about it.
It said that they're coming for me. That they'll see them soon. It was. She'll kind of look at you. It was like I was seeing one of the battles that I was in. And we were fighting, of course, the tieflings. And we all started running from this black thing that was coming towards us. And I heard the voice of my Deva just telling me that they were coming, that they would find me.
That is.
To kind of lay back down, just kind of lay there looking up. Sorry, I didn't mean to wake you.
No, Eliana, don't worry about it. That is certainly a bad dream. Do you have those often like that?
Not like this. No. Never really like this. I mean, I dream about the battles, of course, a lot. But
can I ask? So I noticed recently from your wings have changed a bit from when I first saw them.
Mm-hmm.
Is this, mind if I just ask about that? If it's too personal, don't feel like you have to share. You know what's causing that? And this have anything to do?
No, I don't know. I've tried asking my deity, Torm. Well, I've tried asking Torm, I'll say. I didn't get an answer. As usual lately. So I don't know if it's because I'm not... Well, I mean, you probably noticed I haven't really visited a church or prayed a lot lately. So I'm not sure if it's because of that or... I don't know.
Are you having... Did I notice that? I think I noticed you once before, a very long time ago. It seemed like you weren't, you had picked up another holy symbol and you were carrying that about. Do you struggle at all with your faith? When it kind of leans back a little bit and kind of rubs your arm, realizing he's asking some pretty big questions.
I have trouble worshiping something that was okay with the slaughter of thousands, you know? Especially when, you know, I kind of figured out that it was all just smoke, that their reasoning was smoke why they were fighting the Tieflings. It was just because, well, several reasons, but mostly because they had just done it for so long, and then also just because they were something that, you know, that they wanted victory over, that they wanted to almost eliminate, it seemed. So how can I don't feel comfortable anymore praying to something that they all worshipped Torm there for the most part. And so how can I believe in something that's not, that's allows that and that doesn't reprimand it in any way?
Right. That's a very good point. I've always struggled a bit to understand that relationship people have with deities, and as they allow so many dark things to happen. I don't know if I'd be much... I'd have much to offer on that front. I also struggle with that thought, but... If it's important to you, your the faith itself, perhaps... seeking some guidance on that from... your church, or...
Maybe. We're just never in one place long enough to really think about it. But right. I guess... But you're okay, right? I mean, you don't worship anything, and...
I feel alright. I certainly believe in the deities, right? They've shown plenty of influence in the past and present, but no, I don't worship him, and I feel like I'm all right. But I know it's a bit different, you know, for you and in the work you do, and...
I don't even know what... I mean, the work I do was for the Empire. You know, I mean, I'm out here now. What am I doing but fighting and just surviving and... working with y'all and being here with you, and she'll smile. I'm not really utilizing, you know, so, or being utilized.
Right.
So what is it all for, I guess?
Well, maybe spend some time considering more of what you want. From what you've shared, you've sort of been force-fed a lot of this since you were a youth and given over to the Empire. Maybe spend some time. Maybe this paladin's life isn't for you, but something else altogether. What feels right to you? Figure that out, and we're all here to help you follow wherever that leads you. I'm here.
Imagine her just kind of laying on her side, looking at you, and she'll give you a kiss, and let's try and go back to sleep.
All right.
Thank you, Linnick.
Of course.
I'm glad that you're... Well, I'm glad that you're in my life.
That's a love extra.
That's it. She'll try to go back to sleep.
You find the rest of your night relatively restful. And all of you wake the next morning. Mm-hmm. What are we up to?
Should we hit the road, or do you guys want to hang out here for a little while longer?
I think I'm ready whenever everyone else is.
Sure. Yeah. We should probably go tell the people on the boat what we're going to do before we leave, because they might be here for a while.
Oh, yeah. That's a good idea.
But I don't think, they just made a huge bonus. I think they're still happy.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Well, I'll go tell the crew. Is there anything else we need to let them know? Or?
No, I think they'll be, you think they'll be safe in this particular port, or should we have them run up the coast to...
I mean, I don't think they're going to get attacked here.
Right.
I think we'll just have to pay the docking fee, which is...
Right.
Yeah.
Whatever.
We'll just make sure they know that. I know some of them, I think, were aware of being on that list, but just let them all know.
I'm going to let them know that we're working on getting them removed from that list.
Nice. I'm just going to grab, send a message to Artemis, of course, before we head out and use the branch. And we'll go from there.
All right.
That's all right. All right. Oh, maybe a breakfast sandwich or two for the road.
Right. Yeah. Sure. Yes.
I mean, I'll message Artemis, just seeing if he's okay in coming back to travel with us.
So you message him, and he's like, yes, if you'd like me to travel with you, so I'd be happy to.
Oh, wonderful, Artemis. So we're going to here and here, and then to Feywild, and I'll just give him a little brief rundown. where we'll be leaving, you can meet us at Laura's.
I see. All right. I will meet you there then. So, all right. Jules, you make your way to the ship to let them know what's going on, to let them know that they're getting their names taken off. Henry, the bosun, is the one that's speaking with you and asks you, are you sure you don't want us to meet you anywhere in particular? We're not the fastest ship. We're pretty fast, but we're not the fastest ship.
I just don't want you guys to get, like, we made a lot of enemies over the pirate isles, and I don't want you guys getting attacked while we're not here.
I mean, that's fair, but we are fairly well stocked, so if you change your mind, need us to go anywhere, try and...
Sure thing. Actually, I'm going to go get some sending stones. I'm going to give you one, and then you can just call me. Okay. We can stay in contact that way.
Okay. That sounds like a great plan.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, so I'm going to go do that, and then meet everyone for breakfast.
Okay. Got it. Anyone else?
I don't know what's happening anymore.
Tasha just found out the change in the OnlyFans.
Between OnlyFans and the Zoom chat. I just for the ride tonight.
Get with the times, Tasha.
Listen.
That's awesome.
My grip is not weird.
Okay, so the sending stones will be 430.
She's used to triangles, that's why she's grabbing.
Yes.
Kind of. I'll just take a drink.
You know what's sad is when I got knocked out by that big ogre, I drew that image and I made it a triangle, like really specifically, but she wasn't there for it.
Yeah, it's true.
Oh.
So yeah, I guess we'll
let's go.
Touch a stick and then.
Right, hold my stick.
Okay, so you travel just a little ways out of town because most of it has been cleared as the city has been growing, and you touch a fairly large tree with the totem stick that was given to you by Javier, and the tree itself opens up with that sort of shimmery gold light, and you step through the tree and find yourselves deep within sort of the jungled forest, coming out of the overly large treant, Javier.
All right, blushing, no doubt.
I'm sorry, Javier.
No, Eliana, do not apologize. Dear Eliana, I wouldn't have given you the gift if I didn't want you to use it.
Went through a tree.
Yeah.
Oh, right,
yeah.
You have a new Javier. Friend.
This is Finn.
Ben, this is Javier.
Finn.
Yes.
That hurt.
Javier is very accommodating.
Right.
Oh, we just came out of you.
Yeah.
It's more of a portal, little one.
Right. People come in people all the time.
It's true. Oh. It's
Yeah.
Yep.
Different places.
Yeah.
It's done. It's done.
That happens.
I can't.
So Javier, where we're at? Where are you on your way to? Where do you know?
If you were on this map.
We're looking for either the Cassidothian Pass or, oh God,
Vog Maldir, which is there. Just before it, I think.
You are most likely closer to Vog Maldir.
Perfect.
Oh, all right. Wonderful.
And then, Javier, I had a question.
Yes.
Let's say we needed to get to the Feywild. Not permanently, just temporarily. How would we do that?
You could take one of the rifts. I could show you where one has been located, although I've been trying to close it.
Would it be possible to keep it open for us to travel to and back through?
How long do you need to have it open for?
Oh, well, we need to go to Vog Maldir, and then we need to teleport to you pretty much immediately if you're outside of it.
I see. It's about 2 days travel from where we are now. So I would need those 2 days to travel there.
Okay. And then I'm going to look at the map with Lennox, and we're going to try and deduce how long it would take to get to Vog Maldir.
Can you guys do investigation checks for me, please?
Absolutely. I'll, can I just give Lennox advantage?
Sure, yeah.
Thank you. Sorry, the music started going to Elton John, and I just want to make sure I was in.
I'm still playing.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm still playing the.
That's your own playlist. Weird.
Yeah, I don't. Well,
I don't understand. Blame you.
I love Elton John. Nice. Why is it not? It says I'm connected to you. There.
Dan's listening to his own soundtrack over there. It seems.
Yeah. Does not want to. Behave. I'm so sorry. Okay.
To the beat of his own Elton.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Hold me closer, Tony Danza. All
right. Awesome. Sorry, I'm doing which check now with advantage? A survival?
Investigation, please.
Oh, nice. Okay. Those are terrible rolls, but I have a D. Good. Thankfully, I have a plus 10. It's 18. I rolled a 1 and an 8.
Ooh.
18. All right. That's good enough to tell that you're probably about a day's travel out from Vog Maldir. From where you are. Yeah.
Pretty close.
This forest is right next to it. Yeah.
So we'll go there, we'll wait a day, and then teleport to Javier. Because mm-hmm. Javier needs 2 days to get there.
Mm-hmm.
And fucking figure it out from there, I guess. Like, I don't know what to do once we're on the other side.
Find a place to go. Do we have a... Did it? Did they not give us any... Derek, did they not give us any information about where we have to go there? Oh, yeah, you have something that's supposed to take us once we get to the Feywild. We do the thing, and then we get there with the thing, right, Derek?
Right, but we have to get to the Feywild.
Right,
but once we do that, we use the stone, it will teleport us
there we go.
Where we need to be.
Yes, perfect.
Okay.
Rich?
Let's go.
What I little I know about the Feywild, let's spend as little time there as we need to.
Agreed, I think. Mm-hmm.
It's a beautiful place, as it's been described to me, but very dangerous.
Okay. Well, Javier, I'll fill them in on our plan.
All right.
I'd like to mentally... go ahead.
We'll have to warn you. Travel back from the Feywild. It may not be the same time here as when you left.
Mm. Yeah.
So...
I'm sorry?
If it's too long, I may have to close the rift.
Wait, what? So time travels differently there?
That is correct. But it's not a linear change. You can never tell. It could be minutes when you come back. It could be the same amount of time that has passed. It could be decades.
Oh my. Okay.
Yeah, this is gonna fucking suck.
If it's decades, do we come back decades older, or are we the same as when we left?
It would be the same as when you left, because you were in the Feywild.
Okay, all right.
All right, well, let's hoping that we're not there for a long time, because that'd be a real weird conversation to have with my parents.
Great.
Yeah.
I'll mental message everyone too. Did we just decide against telling Javier about this Archfey being part of whatever ring it is to keep these things open?
No.
We can tell him. I think it'd be better to if he knows him and he's like, "Oh, that guy's a real dick." Like, then we know not to. I don't know his name though. I don't know who it is.
Notes. There's no compass. Javier, we also just wanted you to know.
Yes.
We discovered while out in city to the west, Nokomis, that there's this Archfey that we're dealing with. Is part of some ring of people that are intentionally keeping these portals open. They have people working for them that keep them open. There was one just around that city. I think they said there were three or so in total.
See, that would explain why they seem to keep opening every time we close one. Thank you for your warning.
Of course.
It would also explain why we couldn't tell how they were being opened. Clearly the ring opened from the Feywild. Useful.
Oh, good. Did anyone catch the name of the Archfey?
Derek, did he tell you? The name? I mean, I don't know. I mean,
I don't think so, but this is Steven talking. I don't think he... unless he said it to the group at the beginning, we didn't have a conversation about it.
No, well, and then that's it.
Because Aaron. She probably did.
We didn't.
It was Aaron.
Well, okay, but I'm not sure that the name that he would use here would be the same as his Archfey name, Linnick.
Oh, no, I highly doubt that.
Yeah.
Javier, do you know any Aarons?
Much like this name, Javier, that you gave me, I'm not very familiar with your mortal or immortal names.
Pretty sure he would have, and Maeve didn't. She just mentioned that it sounded like an archfey, not that it sounded like a particular one, and she gave me a name for it. Just.
That's all I have written down is Aaron the Eladrin from the Fey.
Right.
I wrote something down.
Well, if we discover anything more, we'll be sure to share it with you, Javier.
Yeah.
This good news. We could use good news. It's been trying, Javier.
Come on.
Thank you. I knew you were the right people to entrust.
You're too kind.
Now, I must be off if I'm to meet you in 2 days.
Yes, we'll see you in 2 days, and then hopefully we will not be gone that long. I'm going to immediately use the sending stone with the crew.
Okay.
And I'm going to fill them in.
Okay.
They're going with the Feywild.
If we're not back in 3 years.
And I know that the sending stones work through different planes. So I'm going to say, hey, after an hour, just shoot me a message. Just so I have some grasp of how long an hour is in there. Just giving them, I'm just updating them on the plan.
Okay.
Because I don't want them fucking waiting for like 10 years for us or something like that. All right. Well, for now, let's go to Vog Maldir. All right. And
so we have 24 hours from when we buy the crepes. We buy them, and where are we headed?
Jump to Javier. It should be a matter of minutes. Right. It should be a matter of minutes before we're there.
Excellent. All right. Let's we don't have any horses or anything. Let's begin the travel.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Let's go.
Can I just get a survival check from you, Lennox? Since I take it you're the one who are.
Yeah, I'll use my book. Ooh, okay, that's 17 plus.
I can also help with that.
Two.
If needed.
That's a 19, which is probably Lennox's best survival roll to date. Usually complete crap.
Pretty crap. Okay. 19. Yeah. You know, you don't make a great time, but you do make it pretty late in the evening. It's probably close to 9, 10 o'clock at night when you you see Vog Maldir right on the horizon.
Oh, I kind of wiped my brow. Like, good. It was the right way. We're here. Almost. Oh. Ahead then to Vog Maldir, or it's in sight.
Yeah. And then we got a day to burn, correct?
Right. If we need that
to wait for Javier to get
the day for Javier.
Yeah, we should wait a day.
Yeah.
All right.
Or maybe a day and a half, just to give him time in case something happened.
That's fair.
Right. Right. Oh.
We. It's more important that he is there than any other part of this plan.
Correct.
Should we, since we have a day and a half,
go to the spa? Yes.
Oh, definitely. We can do. We can take turn rubbing backs.
Yeah.
But also have a contingency plan. What if we go? We bath to Javier, and something terrible's happened, or is elsewhere entirely.
Well, then Derek's fucked. That happens.
So the bad news is I think that Derek accepted the thing on behalf of all of us.
Derek, did you say this is from... Did you go to the guy and you were like, this is from me and the boys? Or did you just say it's just me doing this?
I said it was me, but he said that he was glad that the party decided to do it.
And you didn't clarify in any way.
I did say that... What I tried to do was say that it was a token of my appreciation for healing my hands, but I really don't think he took it that way primarily.
So you didn't, that has nothing to do with what I just asked you. Did you tell him specifically that it's with from you?
I did, but I'm just telling you what he said back.
Okay, and then after that,
uh-huh,
you didn't attempt to correct his acknowledgement of what you did.
No.
Thank you, dear. And Jules is going to go off and just scream. Jules is like walking into the woods and just screaming.
Eliana will slowly kind of like approach Jules. Jules, could you not just... Could we spend our time there? Maybe you said you might know someone in the college that could, at the university, that could help us maybe get to portal to the Fae? So maybe if we have a backup plan, you know what I mean?
That's good. That's a good idea.
I did. Are you out of my talk shot?
No.
I'm screaming. Agree that I would deliver them.
Right. I don't think that helps.
So I think it's fine for me to only take the risk.
No, we're all going to the Feywild together. We're not going to send you in there alone.
Well, what's the worst thing that could happen?
It's fine. We're all going to go in there together because that's what we do. Yeah. Welcome to the team. So we can spend our extra time or extra day trying to find someone in the city that could possibly open up a portal to the Feywild Forest, just in case.
Right.
The Javier thing, unfortunately, hopefully doesn't fall through.
Okay.
Sound good to everyone?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll see if I can talk to Grim Frida.
All right.
And we'll go from there.
Right. Okay.
All right, so you find an inn to stay in for the evening. Anything else you want to accomplish? I know it's kind of late at night for you.
Yeah.
No.
Oh, so on our way, are we staying at the inn that we stayed at before?
I don't know, it's up to you guys.
Ideally, yeah, yes.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Was that the harried tortoise? The one?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Eliana would totally kind of, when the group is walking towards, I just want to check on something real, and she's going to see if the theater is still there, and if there's a marquee on the theater.
The theater is definitely still there. It's a little out of your way. You actually, it's right across the road from the crepe shop.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on.
Wasn't it a crepe cart? Too, wasn't it just like some random like
no it was like a it was like a little it was tiny it was a tiny little space. Gotcha. Yeah, but it was it had its a long line. All I can think of is Biscuit Bitch. Steven, we've messaged too much.
Oh man, Biscuit Bitch.
I know, that's immediately what I had in my mind when
as soon as we walked into the city, Elena will be like, hold on a second, and she's going to put on her Viking hat that she bought in the city before.
Let's see. Nope.
Gosh,
the Viking hat has the two straws, right? Isn't that what they?
No. It was just the Viking hat. She didn't get the one with the beard because she didn't want to be wearing a beard and look weird around Linnick. Mm-hmm. So that was the reasoning behind that decision. Because that was.
Yeah. So
before everything.
Yes. So you do go to the. You go to the theater and that you see the marquee says that they are currently showing Madame Arabella and her amorous dragon, which is also a Derek Partson production.
I want to go. Oh my god.
Sorry, Madame Arabella and the polyamorous dragon?
It just says the amorous dragon right now, but
nope, it's not polyamorous.
No, you need to watch it to find out.
Can we? Wait, are we all like in a group 11. Or?
It'll be a treat if we get back in one piece.
Yeah, yeah, I think
a treat. A good way. I say.
Well,
we
have all day tomorrow. If we're waiting a day and a half, we have an entire day tomorrow. Go.
I think it's so sold
finding
out
information.
I want to go.
And what?
Only because I think I'll put it in chat.
Yeah, no, exactly. I'm trying to stall for that too.
What do you mean?
I think it's sold out. I don't know if I could, the tickets might be sold out. I also don't know if I could appreciate the art right now with the stress that I'm feeling.
Oh, God. I'm feeling no stress, and I would like to go see this play.
Noted.
I mean, just to let you know. Oh, okay. Just to let you know.
That is why Lennox and Jules are stalling.
Yeah. Is that a good reason to stall, Vic? In the Zoom chat?
It could be.
It depends on us, I guess.
Right. Yeah.
You cannot do it. That's fine. You could have had to close down for cleaning, Victoria.
I'm just saying that's what's available right now.
Okay. Yeah, that's fine. We can see it when we get back.
Great.
If we come back through this way, I guess. Oh, I don't know. How does the Feywild work? Linnick, do you go? Well, you've never been there, but do you know if you go in and do you come out the same way you went in?
I'll give you a wink.
What?
Well, that depends, I suppose. But I think that typically, there are places that overlap the two, that they're just permanent. They're there, and you know, once it's opened, if it's stable, you come back through it. Which sounds like what this is. But it depends on how we get back. There's other means. I think there's spells that can do it, and that might deposit you back wherever you are. It sort of overlaps the prime. Location-wise, sort of, too, I think.
I do see a sign that this is the last, that tomorrow is the last night for Madam Arabella. So
I want to go.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
I want to go.
So, we can see. What?
We get it. You want to go.
So, okay.
Do
okay.
you?
Finn. I don't think Finn. You do. Finn.
Yes, ma'am.
Just so that you can, I will warn you.
Once you'll see
Derek. Sorry. And she's going to kind of take Finn off to the side. I will warn you, the last one was a bit. Have we explained that to you? Have we told you about it yet? It was a bit interesting. It's not the best. Maybe if you go in expecting a real, have you ever seen a play?
Did they have plays at Ikram?
Have you ever watched? Oh, yeah, I'm sure they did.
So bad.
So have you ever went and saw a play and thought it was going to be really good and then it wasn't and you were, Have you ever went in and expected something to be terrible but then you found out it was really like it was so bad that you found it to be good?
I don't think so. Because we just didn't go to a whole lot of shows or plays. The Ikram thing was more of a, after a big fight and we had a lot of money to spend, then we would go hang out.
So let's say this. Tomorrow, if we find out we have extra time and you still want to go, I guess I can go with you.
That'd be so great. It'd be like a girl's trip.
Maybe. Well, sure. We can ask, unless you want it to be just us.
I don't care.
Ileana's getting flashbacks now.
Yes. I like to experience new things and new places. And if it's a really bad play, I kind of want to be a part of that.
Sure. We can ask the fellas if they want to go as well. So.
Sure. What makes it bad, though? Is it the performers? Oh,
a lot. There's a lot, but you'll see. She'll give her like almost a too firm pat on the shoulder and go back to the group.
Okay.
Welcome back.
I promised that if she still wanted to go tomorrow and we still had time, that I would at least go with her. The rest of you are more than welcome to come as well, but you don't have to.
Well, if there's tickets for sale and such, I'd hate to miss it, right?
Ileana will put a hand on your shoulder, Lydic, and just be like, say to you mentally, please accompany us.
Yeah, right. I think for nostalgia's taken over. I think I will just see how it's changed from.
Sure.
You know, from the last play.
It's a different play. Oh, it's sure. Like how it's different.
Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Oh, cool. Yeah. I can go by myself. That's not a big deal.
No, I don't think it's something. Right. I mean, I don't think you should go and see it by yourself. It's really that bad.
You should, right.
Okay.
I mean, it's.
How is Derek looking with us talking about this play?
He's trying to pretend he's not there.
Okay, all right, that's worse.
Pretending to be distracted by
Ileana will go over to Derek and like put a hand on his shoulder. I'm sure it's great.
I doubt it is.
Do you ever see your own? Have you ever seen your own play, Derek, performed, or do you just write them and send them out into the world?
Well, I typically had starred in many of them, so.
Oh.
This was literally a different lifetime. And he'll just hang his head.
Aww. Ileana will give you like a very awkward like pat on the shoulder, kind of processing what you just said.
Hey, why can't you perform?
Writer, director, starring.
Yeah. I'll hug Derek. I mean, you're still a star to me, but.
I don't understand. Why can't you perform? She doesn't know.
I don't know you well enough to tell you the story.
Okay. I'm still very, very excited to see it, if that's okay with you.
Looking forward to it.
It was quite the experience the last time.
So it's going to be a blast.
But I suppose we should take care of business then, so we can make sure we have the team.
I'm actually just going to head out right now and see if I can leave a note for Grim Frida.
Right. At 11 o'clock at night?
Yeah.
Oh, I think he's in good.
Oh, that's right. Okay, well, I completely forgot.
We spent the most time
together
around 11.
That was a very interesting, okay. Mm. All right.
We're friends. She's a cool girl.
Yeah.
Wonderful. All
right. So yeah, Victoria, I'm going to write it out. It just says, you know, Graham Frieda, this is Jules, I'm in town, I'd love to see you. A few questions, let's meet for drinks. I'm only here till tomorrow. Be nice to see you before then, before I leave.
Sure. Are you hand delivering it, or are you just like sending it with like a courier? So
the chocolate? I'll send it with like, I don't know. I'll send it with some chocolate, just like a truffle.
Okay.
Yeah.
Noted. Okay. Great. So that gets delivered. Thank you. Anyone else this evening?
I try and see if. Oh, please go ahead.
No, I was going to say, then I'll just keep reading the book.
Okay. Unless you cut into your sleep schedule, you can probably get another 3 hours in.
Okay.
Before bed.
Nice. Just gonna document it.
Is this the tome?
Or a no, different book? This is a different book.
Okay, gotcha. Yeah, I guess I would, you know, just see who was up for a walk about the city at night. Asking, okay. Derek.
Ileana would go, of course.
You guys have fun. This is a required reading. I'm gonna just...
Understood.
Get this done. Okay.
Ben, Derek, would you like to come with us then?
Nice little walk.
Yes.
Right, see the sights. Good. Yeah. Grab a drink here and there.
Drink sounds great. Maybe we could get some crepes.
No, we can't get crepes.
Oh no, we can't get any crepes specifically until
it just sounds so good with a mimosa.
I know. Well, we can get like a donut. Like we can get something that's not a crepe.
Okay.
Yeah.
You guys are getting donuts.
If we can find them, I don't. Yeah.
I would know a donut spot, right, Victoria?
Sure, yeah, you've been in the city. Yeah, I mean, yeah, there's like a little place that is like fantastic cronuts that everyone raves about.
We just have to make sure they're not crepes.
Yeah.
Yes. Be very specific.
Bear claws.
These aren't crepes, right?
Yeah.
No.
There's no parts of crepes that get cooked in the same area or anything that would fall into this.
Are there? There's no traces of crepes.
I have a crepe allergy.
Oh,
what?
Man.
Anyway, yeah, Aletic just wants to chill and have some drinks with this, you know, Ben, who's new to the group, and Derek, who I haven't been able to hang out with too much, especially when out and about. So, and
Eliana would probably tell the story about how going over parts of what happened the last time they were in the city, and, you know, that they got the hats, and, you know. She'll tell Finn that if you want to get the hat, we can if they're still there, we can see if they're open tomorrow. And
there's hats.
They have hats. They have beards. I didn't get a beard. I just got the hat. But
you look over. Lennox will have his on at one point. Like surprise.
Yeah. Yeah. See, that's the beard hat. Actually, mm-hmm. Lennox didn't get a beard hat.
Oh, I did.
He got like a cap. Like a
page
newsboy.
Boy.
Yeah. Yes, that's cap. Right. Yeah. On these. Yeah. And I was like Monic just thinks it's the shit.
They have those hats. They have all kinds of different hats at this place. So we also, I guess, someone has a crazy straw still. I mean, that might be in my inventory.
Are they like these?
Yes. You already have one.
You bought one on the way in. You sly bastard.
I'm clipping that. Steph's face. Oh my god.
That's weird. But okay. To each their own.
Amazing.
Learn something new about you every day. It looks good with your hair. It kind of kind of blends together.
Right?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I don't have time to button these, but it's there.
It looks good.
Thank you. Thanks. They don't fit with my headphones on, but
we went to see the play. Yeah.
A lot of
fun.
It just sounds so exciting.
They have a very nice spa here. I think this was where we went to the spa. Or was that the pass?
I think that's the path. Like, path. Okay. Yeah, once we go through,
all right. End up in. Okay. Mm-hmm. I mean, but I do have a spa. I have a pocket spa.
Where's a spa?
There a spa in your pocket?
Maybe we can. mental message, Elian. I mean, I'm all up for Sharon, but maybe we could just spend a night there, you know.
Yeah, I did have a spot, but I can't find it, Fen. I must have.
Oh.
Yeah, it's just at the bottom of the bag. I'll bring it out some other time.
The hardest to get.
Yeah. Just kind of slips away from you like that.
Insight check.
No! Well, here's the thing: is Iliana 20. is proficient at deception,
and I'm proficient in insight.
This is exactly what you had in mind when you chose deception.
Okay, that is a 24 total.
Fuck, I had a 20. Shit.
Oh, that's really good too. Oh my gosh. Oh well, with that, I'm a bit partied out. Appreciate y'all.
Yeah,
coming along for this. but here, I look forward to getting back together. Let's all head back together.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Derek, you doing okay?
Can that insight apply to Linux too?
I'll roll if you want. Yeah, sure. Because I'm being.
Y'all are being so ridiculous. Okay.
All right, well, I rolled a 15, but I have a plus 9, so 24 as well. Me. Oh, it's twin 24s!
Wow.
Man, they're really in sync. They're more in sync than the band in sync.
We're so deceptive.
Gonna be me.
The deceptive duo.
God damn it.
Nice. Okay, fine. I just called and think a band. I'm going to mute myself.
Forever.
Steven, I appreciated that.
Fine, whatever. So we walk back to the place, you know, to the inn, whatever it is.
Nice, yeah. Just want to make sure we're all walking back together is my, you know, just keep an eye.
Together. Yes. Okay, good night. Bye.
Bye. I'm going to go to my
room. Just going to just check on something here at the desk.
Right, right. I forget which room was. Yeah. Forgot to check in, actually.
yeah. We're going to go and do that. Good night, Derek and Finn.
Hey.
As soon as they're up the steps. Right.
Mm-hmm.
Can I turn to Derek?
That's always a dangerous proposition.
Hey, are they always that weird? I don't know a better word.
No. Are they out of earshot by now? I mean, talk shot.
We're beating feet.
they want to go have sex.
Oh.
Yeah, there was a lot of tension for a long time, and I don't know if they're ever going to get over that. So.
Well, you know what? They it's better to find each other and eliminate that tension by doing something productive.
Well,
like sex.
Yeah.
They just didn't want, you know, they didn't want to make you feel like they didn't want to hang out with you, but they also didn't, they're kind of like olds.
Okay.
They're just real mild mannered until they get alone, in which case I think they're actually the kinkiest people in the Isles. That's a
I don't know. But good to know.
Oh, walk by.
Says the guy who reanimated dead animals.
Yep. Yep. Yep.
So, yeah. Well, okay, but that's good to know.
So, are you a fan of the theater? Did you have something like that under the waters?
I never really.
I hear there's like a. They don't have like pageants where the leader's daughters come and sing.
I mean, if they did, I never attended them. I
thought they were really popular.
I mean, I'm sure they had them. I was more focused on fighting.
Oh.
So I didn't really have a lot of time.
What about like exploring for artifacts? Did you do that? Like try and find like things from people that lived on the land that had fallen into the water? Maybe when you were supposed to be singing? No? Okay.
I mean, no. It's,
Dingle.
Dingle hopper.
I have a rage problem sometimes, you know? So I had to channel that somewhere.
Oh.
And I mainly fought a lot.
Oh, what?
And then...
When you say fight, you mean like going out and killing monsters or just getting in bar fights or like sparring?
It was a sparring thing, but like matches. So like I always was the one that went up against people. And then if you win, you get money.
You're a professional fighter?
That's kind of what I did. Yeah.
Oh.
I get angry a lot. And I couldn't just go around like destroying shit. I had to channel it somewhere.
Oh. Then why didn't we go into that dragon lair and fight stuff in Pearl Harbor? Why didn't we go tear shit up in Pearl Harbor?
I don't know. What? Oh.
The Pearl Dragon.
No, it was Pearl Harbor.
The harbor was covered in pearls.
Yeah, it was Pearl Harbor.
It was.
That's a good point. You know, for someone who talks about fighting all the time, you should have missed that one.
Because Tasha wasn't available in shit. So I had to talk to a dragon. Shut the fuck up.
I'm sorry. That was too... That was low-hanging fruit.
I can't. Oh my god, you guys.
Sorry, everyone watching.
I felt like I needed to talk to a dragon because I've never met one, so I don't play board games. Don't know.
Board games?
I don't know. Listen. I lost my chapstick.
Oh no.
I know. It's fine. Next time, I will make sure the person playing me is available to help you in the next fight. But
the sea person thing.
It's a sea person thing, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm suddenly very tired. Yes. And I'm not saying that because I'm going to go have sex. I'm going to lay
You're actually
going to
go to
myself.
Bed.
Yeah.
Okay. Nice.
Well, I just wanted to be clear.
You don't have to sugarcoat things around me. Like, if you're going to go have sex, like, whatever.
I can't get into activities like that in this town. I just...
Well, I had fucking a bender last time.
It was
the sounds we heard.
Derek was in such a dark fucking place.
Really?
He's always had bags under his eyes.
Like, but you could see, even though I had fur.
Oh no!
Just cocaine rings around his soul.
Are you addicted?
Let's just say that I got pretty deep into that situation.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
It was fucking wild.
Pretty here, folks.
To each their own, man.
And I'm, and now I'm, I think I'm weirdly accidentally somewhat devoted to someone. And so I'm trying not to get any STDs.
Well, okay, that's always...
Oh, wait, STCs, sexually transmitted curses. Mm. I don't know what they are in this form.
I love that, STCs. Yeah, that's yeah. You gotta wrap that shit, man.
Oh. Anyway, well, thanks for talking a little bit. It's nice to get to know you some.
Yeah, same.
And then before he leaves, he's like starts to walk away and he turns back and he says, "Hey, Finn. Yeah. Don't go see that play. Oh. It's shit." And then he walks off.
Oh no. Oh no.
Oh man.
But I still want to see. Oh, okay. Wow. Jules, are you still there?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, cool. I guess I need a drink.
Cool. There's a bar just down the street. Two lefts and then.
Thanks. Thank you. Thanks. If
did I break Dan?
And he's gone. He's gone.
Dan, when did you put your Linux makeup on? You weren't red last time I looked. Oh god. Someone needs to come give him air.
No.
Man dies on stream.
Yeah.
This is not what we need.
Oh my god.
There'd be a power vacuum between Victoria and Stephanie. So I'm just afraid of that. Bloodshed.
Don't you worry, it'll just be driving dungeon craft all
day.
Oh
my god. Okay, well, Finn's off.
Finn, I'm joking. Honestly, I would join you, but I have to read this book.
No, that's, I mean, you do you. I'm gonna go to a bar and don't wait up for me. And she'll go to a bar. You're muted,
Vic.
Yeah, thank you. You just go into the first one you find, or the one that he directed you to, or
did he direct me to a decent one?
I don't know.
Jules.
Yeah, I wouldn't have steered you to just like a place to get robbed or anything like that.
You didn't send her to that gambling den?
No.
Oh god.
Yeah. No. Yeah. So yeah, you're able to find a little pub right around the corner.
Okay.
Local joint.
Awesome. Cool. I may or may not make it back home, but I'll meet up with them in the morning, depending on what happens.
Mm-hmm. All right, so everyone has their assignments, I guess, for the evening.
Get some massage really out of here. Gonna get the oil out.
You animals. All right. Morning comes. So what do you guys want to do?
Guys, I'm just going to hang out here, wait to see if I get a message.
All right.
And then I'll work on securing another method of travel.
Ileana has like two coffees in her hand.
Nice, yeah.
Okay. We all Ileana thanks. I'm just grabbing it.
Was there another means you had, Ileana, that may have mentioned someone else as well?
That was in the Cassadonian Pass, so we've already, that's already not an option anymore. Which is fine, because we have Javier, and maybe Jules can get a connection, and they won't even be needed.
Open.
Can I get a persuasion check from you, Ben, please?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay.
Hold on, sorry.
Mysterious.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Ironically, Finn is into deep domes as well.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Shared in
All right. So about mid-morning, I would say you get a note back, Jules, from Frida, telling you that she would love to clear her evening so she can, you know, have drinks with you. Just let her know when and where, and she will make it happen.
Sure. I'll pick, you know, a nice tapas place. And
did you say tapas or topless?
Tapas. Tapas.
Tapas.
Oh, okay.
I heard topless. I heard topless first, tapas. Too. But
tapas.
I'm like, okay.
Topless tapas. No, yeah, all dinner time, like a late dinner, like 8:00.
Okay, all right, done and done. Notice sent. She'll meet you there.
Cool. And then I'm literally gonna read all day.
Okay, great.
Like from the moment I wake up until I have to go meet her.
Okay, all right. I'll do the math on that. What is everyone else doing?
Derek wants to go to the theater and get in touch with the director to deliver his manuscript.
Ooh.
Great. Anyone else?
Ben would have gotten a coffee or something as she's making her way back to the inn.
Okay.
I'll just be chilling there with everyone that's there. Jules, Ileana.
Okay. All right. So, Derek, you head over to... I literally just had it. I'm sorry. So much scrolling. Mm-hmm. circling the theater of silver, and you see that there there's a lot of buzz around because it's the final evening of Madame Arabella. Make your way in. You meet the manager there. Who you give the script to. Is there anything you want to explain to them before you hand it over?
No, because Derek puts pretty detailed stage directions and stuff, and it's not like the show on right now is like a kabuki, and so it's a lot more complicated, like with stage directions. This one is not. It's fairly straight and self-explanatory.
Okay.
He'll look and he'll say, "There's only one song," and that's the only thing he'll tell him.
All right. Is this a Derek Barson original? How do you know the man?
Well, that's me, and this is my newest work.
Can you make a persuasion check for me, please?
Yeah, I can.
So persuasive.
I've rolled a 6.
You've got your thing, too.
Wait, I'm using my thing.
I rolled a 6, so use it.
Okay. Okay. That would be on brand. okay. Okay.
Was it low and then it switched the last second?
19. Yeah, I thought
19.
It was.
19. Okay.
It's going to be like a 2.
Yeah.
Okay.
You see this older gnome just kind of like stare at you a second and say, "You're not what I expected, but my goodness.
I'm not what I expected
here.
Either.
I don't even know what to say. Of course, we'll get started on this right away. We had planned for another play, but this will be the next one, of course."
And Derek will give a bow and say, "If the play is successful, keep the profits with the theater and use it to upgrade to your heart's content. That's all I ask."
"You're so generous. Of course, would we can probably have this turned around in 3 days' time."
Oh my God. That was Steven.
Would you be available to be here for opening night?
Oh. I'm going on a bit of a dangerous mission, perhaps. If I can make it, I will be here.
Of course. We'll save you a box for as many nights until you're able to return.
Thank you. And he'll just give another like deep bow and walk away.
Okay. You see like almost tears in this gnome's eyes now that he's met the man behind
the he has the only copy of what Derek feels is his masterpiece.
Steven, I'm so afraid, Steven.
It's one song.
It only has one song.
It only has one song.
I lost
the other one. The other one had songs between each.
Yes, all of his previous shows did.
Yeah. Okay, so they're preparing.
Victoria.
Yes, ma'am.
Would Ileana have seen any temples coming through the town? Mm. They've been walking.
Will you make a perception check for me, please?
Sure. Oh, God. I swear, every time it's anything to do with religion, that's a 12.
A 12? You know, it's a very large, sprawling city, and it's hard to see because it is very hilly. It's sort of like built into this mountain pass. So you don't recall seeing.
Okay. Okay.
I mean, you know, Jules knows a lot about the city, but you don't ever remember seeing anything. So.
Okay. Jules is making his connection, right? Or is he there kind of hanging out with like where Linux and stuff would be?
I'm making the connection.
Okay.
Tonight.
Right. But are you hanging out with the group at all today?
No, I'm just strictly reading.
Oh, okay. In your room?
I'll be around. But yeah.
Okay. Well, she would maybe find you out and sometime during the day. Jules, do you know if there are any temples here in the city, specifically I mean, I don't know, either interdenominational, you know, that I can not have to worship their god to work, you know, to go in there, or sure. to one to, I don't think they would have one, but to Torm specifically.
I will search my member banks, DM. But here, I'm gonna.
Do not power down.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Is that possible?
Sure. Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, that fits our guidelines.
Yeah.
If possible.
Yeah.
I would imagine it does.
Give me one.
Interdenominate.
Yeah. Uno momento, por favor. Sure. Let's see here. Man. Yes, you do know of one. It's in the Great Stale District. You can tell her that it's right next to this ancient abbey ruins that's said to be haunted of the spirits that were slain upon the altar before the abbey itself was destroyed, that they've created a church directly next to it.
Send a clarification message. Does that, was I right on that or was I incorrect? On that type of temple,
it can be like that. Yeah,
that's the one. But
okay.
Yeah.
Uh huh.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep. You don't know the name of it, but you do know that that would be like, that's probably your best bet, because you know Jules isn't a religious person, so he doesn't know about all of the temples in the city. But he sends you to that one in particular.
So what was the name of it again?
I don't know where it's located.
So it's beside the haunted abbey?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. All right, thanks. How far does it take to get there?
From an hour across the city.
An hour?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. And she'll let Linnick know. Yeah, just be like, I'm going to step out for a bit. I'll be back.
Of course, love, you take care.
Okay. And she will head out towards the abbey.
All right. So as Ileana heads out towards the haunted abbey, Derek delivers his latest masterpiece to a gnome that is beside himself. Fen comes in from a late evening. Lennox entertains himself before Ileana makes it back, and Jules reads. That's where we will end tonight's session.
Yay!
Yes.
Nice.
All right. Looks like we're going to the Feywild next week, boys and girls.
Well, it's going to be a Feywild time.
I sure hope so.
Good God.
Awesome. All right. Whew, we made it. Super exciting. A couple of just announcements before we start to do our usual end of stream spiel. I think next week we're going to have a special guest. I need to confirm that they were waiting until you showed up at the Feywild before they came along. So fingers crossed they'll be able to make it. And then, you guys, it's episode 67, which means only two more sessions before episode 69.
Yeah.
That's pretty freaking exciting.
Nice.
And,
nice.
In honor of episode 69, we're going to do a bunch of giveaways. We're going to do a t-shirt, a proper naughty t-shirt. We're going to do a very special mug, which we'll send you guys the design so you know what you're getting. We're going to do a bag of dice and dicks, I think, and maybe some other goodies that are in that bag. And then we also have a personalized gift from one of our players. If you get this particular giveaway, you will get a love letter written to you from Derek Bardson. So we'll put you in touch with Steven. Steven will get that customized and sent out to you. So all sorts of giveaways. That'll be in 2 weeks for the 69th episode, which is an important one around here. Mm-hmm. And if you're new to the channel, we play a lot of D&D on this channel. We play D&D on Sunday nights, Monday nights, Tuesday nights, Friday nights, and twice on Saturday nights. On top of that, on Tuesdays from 2 to 4, Steph and I have Dungeon Craft with Steph and Vic. where this week I think we are creating Steph's farmers only account. We're talking about the finer points of farming. And what else were we doing? organizing the what we're gonna need for our crafting session.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Also, we might paint minis and shoot the shit. Mm-hmm. That's what we do. Mm-hmm. On Fridays from 12 to 3 on Mad Art with Steph. Steph illustrates different scenes from around the channel. So if you want to see kind of what she's working on, you can always hop over into our Discord, join our Discord. We have a great community over there, and she will often post works in progress and what she might be working on. And if you like what you saw and you want to support this channel, we highly recommend doing so through our Patreon. It's the same as the Twitch subscription, but you get a little bit more, and we get a little bit more of the money back to invest back into the stream. So if you are willing and able to do that, that is a great way to help support us. Dan, who are we going to raid over to tonight?
Well, we have both Nat 20 TV and Fable 42.
Dealer's choice.
Okay, we'll do I think Fable 42.
Give them all right, let's do it. All right, so if you don't mind hanging out, you guys jump over with them, give them a mad bird hello, caw-caw, and we will see you guys next Sunday for the Feywild episode. All right, bye guys.
Thanks, bye. People.
Bye.